In the recent weeks, I've seen thousands and thousands of applications that look exactly the same. A chatbot, where you can interact directly with ChatGPT. So I got curious about how they are made and decided to make my own. Hey friends, and welcome back to the channel. I'm Donna, a software engineer based in Sydney. And in this video, we'll see how to use the OpenAI API to build your own chatbot. And this is how it will look like. Here you have a chat where you can type your question, send it to the OpenAI API and get an answer. The same way as ChatGPT works, but inside an Android app. Now, let's dive into the implementation. The first step is to connect the Android app with the OpenAI API. For that, there are two different solutions. The first one is to use directly the OpenAI API through creating all of the different objects that you need and use Retrofit and OKHTTP to send the request to the OpenAI API. The second option is to use a library called OpenAI Kotlin that has been made by a user called AALLAM on GitHub that already contains all of these different objects. And that's the solution that I decided to use. You can access that library on GitHub. I will put the link in the description of this video. Importing that library is pretty easy, as you just have to use Gradle for that and add the following lines into your Gradle file. And then just sync your project and boom, you get all of what you need. Next step is to create the OpenAI object and add the OpenAI API token in it. In order to do that, you have to go to the website platform.openai.com and generate a new API key.
Once you are there, you have to click on the right button and then view API keys. Here you can view all of the different API keys that you generated in the past. What we want to do here is to create a new secret key. So we can just click here and then here we can type, for example, Android app chatbot and create secret key. And as you can see, the key is directly shown here, so you can directly copy it here. And now we have the open API key that we can use in our project. So if I go into the project, I have a dependency injection package here, and inside I have a network module, which is a file that contains the network module where I have OpenAI object that is instantiated. Basically what I'm doing here is that I have OpenAI config here with the token. So that's the key that I created previously. And I just return this OpenAI object. There are other parameters that I can set here, but this is the easy setup.
So now let's see how I can add my own API key into the project.
The way that I add this OpenAI API key here to the build config is through the gradle.property. So that file is directly inside the app package here. And here I can directly paste my token. So like this, for example, and then I can just sync my project. And then when I will use the project, it will automatically be available inside the build config object. And then I can just use it like this here.
There's something really important to note here is that you don't want anyone else to have access to your OpenAI key. Reason being that if anyone else uses it, you will be paying for the request. That's why I advise you to not push your API key into GitHub, but instead use gradle.properties file to add that API key. Now that OpenAI object is configured, I can directly inject it in any of my use case or view models or repositories through the project and directly use the OpenAI object. So now let's see how I implemented the chat. The first step is to create model object that I will need through the implementation, which is conversation and message.
So if I go in the project into the chat and data package, I have my conversation repository here. And at the bottom, I have the data classes that I need, conversation and messages. So a message is going to be an ID, which is a random UUID, then a text, which is the text of the message, a boolean saying if that message is from the user or if it's the answer, so for the chatbot, and finally a message status. There's three different message status. One is sending, which means that the message is currently being sent, error, and sent.
So that's it for the model classes. Now let's see how I implemented the OpenAI repository that handle all of the logic with the OpenAI API.
So now I can go to the API package and the OpenAI repository. And here is all the logic that handled sending the conversation to OpenAI API and getting a new message. The first thing you can see here is that we have a chat completion request object that we have to instantiate with different parameters. So the first parameter here is the model, which is the OpenAI model to use. Then you have here the messages, which is a list of chat message. And that's why here I have to transform the conversation object that is my own into a chat messages list. So as you can see, that method is here. So here I have a list. I filter all of the messages that are an error. I filter them out. And then I map basically the text and if it's from the user or not to the library's classes. So if I go to this chat completion request, you can see that there are multiple other parameters like the temperature, the maximum tokens, presence penalty, frequency penalty.
If you have seen my previous video about OpenAI Playground, you can see that all of these parameters that we have in the chat completion request is looking similar to the parameter we were playing around inside the OpenAI Playground. That's because the OpenAI Playground has been built especially for developers in order to practice and experiment different parameters to see what result they will get. If you want more information about OpenAI Playground, feel free to check my video right here, where I really go into details about all the different parameters that you can set and the different results that you can expect.
Let's go back to the code and let's go back to the OpenAI repository. Once I created my chat completion request object, I then can use the chat completion method from the OpenAI library to directly send that request and get a chat completion object back. In that object, we have the ID of the completion, we have the created date, we have the model that we used, and then we have choices, which is a list of all the different chat choice that has been generated from the OpenAI API. And by default, you will have only one item in that list. If you want to change that and get multiple different answers, you can directly change the parameter in the chat completion request when you were sending it. And that parameter is N. So you can set N to like 2, for example, and you will get the 2 best answers for that specific conversation. But here we will just use 1. And then you have usage, which is the total amount of token that you used. Once you get this chat completion object back, you can directly iterate through the choices, take the first one, and then take the first chat message. If there is no messages, which is just a precautious, you can just throw an exception. That's what I'm doing here. And then I embed that message that I get back into my own message object, where I just take the content of that chat message class to set it to the text. I take the role of that chat message class to say if it's from the user or not. And finally, I set the message status of that message to sent. That's it for the OpenAI repository logic.
There are a lot of other things that you can do with the OpenAI API, like for example, generating images or transforming audio file into text. So if you are interested into this type of content, subscribe to the channel as I will be releasing a lot of other videos about OpenAI API and how to use it to the fullest. Now let's continue with the rest of the logic that is not OpenAI related, and more specifically about the conversation handling, and that will be done in the conversation repository.
So if I go into the chat and data package, I have the conversation repository and there a list of all different messages. And that, for example, is the first message that is shown to the user, which is, hi, how can I help? There will also be a conversation flow that will contain the current conversation of the user. Here I decided to go with a conversation stored into the memory. So every time the user reopens the app, the conversation is deleted. But of course, you can store that into a database or into the disk. There are basic functions like add message that just adds a message to the list and publish it to the flow. Resend message that does the same thing, remove a message and add it at the last and then update the flow. And also set message status to send. So this takes an ID of a message and set it to send, and also the same one that set it to error. And finally, update conversation flow. So that method here is just getting a list of messages and posting it into the flow.
We now need to link the conversation repository with our view model and with our view. For that, we will create a use case called Observe Messages use case.
And here what we do is we basically just return the conversation flow of that conversation repository. In the chat view model, I have my observe messages use case that I use directly in this observe message list method that is called on init, that keep observing for any updates for the messages inside that use case that reflects any update in messages in the conversation repository. Every time I get an update, I will post that update into the conversation live data and also into this is sending messages, which is basically checking if there is any messages that is currently being sent, and that will help to show the AI is typing text. So every time there is an update, these mutable live datas will be updated. And then if we look at the chat activity here, I just pass down these two live data into the chat screen, and in the chat screen we just observe them as state, and then we just have to basically add them into the message list here and display for every item in the messages list. We're going to display different UI. This is basic Jetpack Compose code, so I won't spend too much time here, but we basically decide to show the text here. We just add some styling and some background depending on the message status, and that's mainly it for showing the messages.
Now, every time that the conversation repository posts a new message into the flow, the UI will automatically get updated through the use case, the view model, and the view. The next step is to implement the sending of the message, and that will be implemented in the send chat request use case.
In this use case, we are handling the logic of sending the message. So what we are doing here is we are just creating this message object where we put that prompt directly in it as the text. The isFromUser is true because that's a message that the user wants to send, and the message status is sending. And then we call the conversation repository and add that message. So here we will have our conversation with the last message being the message of the user with the status sending. And we will send that to the OpenAI API to get a reply and create a new message from that reply. That's what the send chat request method do, as we saw previously. So in this reply object here, we will have our own custom class message with the answer from the OpenAI API. And we want to add that message into the conversation. So that's what we do in that line. But before doing that, we want to set the message status of the message that we sent to the OpenAI API to sent, as it's not sending anymore. It has been sent as we already received an answer from it. These three lines here are inside a try catch. That's because we can have a network exception, for example. And if that's the case, then we just set the message status of that message to error. Now let's see where we are using this send chat request use case. So as we can see, if we go back to the chat view model, we can see here that we have this send chat request use case. We directly embed that into the send message method here. That is basically just calling the use case with that string. If we go one layer more into the view, this send message is called inside the chat screen. So we can go directly to the chat screen and see where that method is called. And that method is called in the text field here, and either press enter from the keyboard action or click on the button. In that case, we will call send message. That will call the send message method with the value that will then call the view model, that then call the use case. And that's the whole logic that we have.
And this is how the project works. You can check the project on GitHub, and the link will be in the description of this video to have more information or just play around with it. If you like this type of content, don't forget to put a thumb up and subscribe to the channel. If you have any questions, just drop a message in the comment and I will answer it. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video.